Hello, how are we doing today? So Miss Amberlynn Reed is still missing in action. So I was like, okay, what are we gonna do to pass the time? And then I thought of something brilliant. What if we go back in time and see what Miss Amberlynn Reed was doing today in history? I went back to 2019 and there was no video posted on October 15th. But in 2018, there was indeed a video posted on October 15th, simply titled, I Don't Know How to Lose Weight. I am excited to venture back in history with you. Hopefully we can gain some perspective or something. I miss you, Amberlynn. I hope you come back soon. I want to know how Becky's drawing is going. I want to know how that dot-to-dot puzzle is coming along. I would like to see the progress on that hoard bed that you have. Also, those wonderful gentlemen are still working on my roof. Hopefully it's minimal sound because it sounds like that they are like more over there now. So hopefully you barely hear it. Thanks for sticking with me. I love you very much. Let's jump into it.
What are you making, babe?
Yes, I am sitting down. My back hurts. That's not what she asked. I'm making broccoli, chicken, and potatoes.
That sound, though.
I hate that sound, yeah.
I know. But I don't like cutting raw chicken on wood, and that's the only other one that's clean right now, or plastic, because...
What an awful sound.
So, if it was me giving advice, I'd say just cut raw chicken on glass.
Thank you for the advice.
Because you don't want, you know, bacteria to build up. Mm.
Science, no. Lynn. Love that.
And please, after you cut chicken,
wash
don't
your hands.
Touch anything. Wash your hands.
Yes, girl, we love that. Wow.
Or else.
I really don't want to be mean, but I personally notice a difference in her weight. I don't know about you guys. This is 2 years ago, and I genuinely do see a difference in her weight, and it's a little shocking.
Are my underwear showing through my pants?
Yeah.
Are my underwear?
That's not, I'm kidding.
Broccoli.
Look at that broccoli. Doesn't that look good?
What I do is I put lemon in the broccoli and it tastes really good.
Yeah, that's the only way to actually have broccoli. Maybe every now and then, you know, if you want to have broccoli garlic. The bad way, put cheese on it. Growing up, I absolutely hated broccoli, so
I've always loved
now
broccoli.
That I'm older, I'm like, you know what? Broccoli is pretty good.
Mm-hmm. Hey guys, so Becky and I just got done grocery shopping. I actually haven't vlogged in quite a few days, so I do apologize about that. I just wanted to show you guys, doesn't the living room look so weird without that big ottoman in the middle? Why I wanted to show you guys
didn't
this,
you have a mattress there
I don't
too?
Know. The ottoman is in Eric and Ricky's room because we were, me and Becky were sitting on it. We were playing Mario Party last night, but anyways, I just wanted to show you guys. I know it's only October, but this is when they start putting them out, and...
Oh, don't tell me. Don't tell me even 2 years ago she was hoarding unnecessary Halloween decorations. Don't even tell
People
me.
People buy their planners around this time.
Oh, okay. Planner hoard. Okay, got it.
They buy them early to get the goods.
Got
so
it.
So I already bought my planner for 2019. It's super cute. I love the front of it. This is the Happy Planner. This planner actually goes from January 2019 to June 2020. And the inside is super cute. There was one that was already opened. This one's not opened right now, so I can't... like show you guys because I don't want to open it yet, but oh my gosh, I'm so like pumped. I love planners.
Yeah,
and then
know.
I was wearing this gray cardigan today, and at the store I saw a pink one that matched. I was like, okay, this is pretty much the greatest thing ever. So I just wanted to say hello. I'm gonna try vlogging more. Tomorrow is Monday, October 7th.
I also note her eyebrows have really grown in a lot over the past 2 years, just an observation.
So I'll probably start a vlog continuing on from this one, but Becky's actually about to film a paranormal story, which you guys have been waiting for, which you'll probably see before this vlog anyway. So get excited. There's gonna be a couple, probably about 4 videos of some paranormal stories. I don't have any, but she does. Hey guys, so I actually haven't vlogged in a few days. That last clip you saw was probably
that bra strap, all the pilling she's suffering.
Like 5 days ago.
Oh,
I wanted
wow.
to show you guys what I have been having for breakfast lately. It's only been a few days, but still, it's actually really good.
It is hash browns with egg and onion.
Wasn't she allergic to eggs?
Some sriracha on top. As for the weight, this is not like a good angle, I'm so sorry. As for the Weight Watcher points, you guys can't even see my face, that's goals.
Can you see my face now?
Okay, I'll stop being weird. So yes.
That shirt, like just the pilling on her like outfit moment, just since it's right in my face, just noticing that.
The cheese to mine, but this time I didn't. So for 2 cups of the hash browns is 8 points, and I use 2 cups. I use 2 eggs, which is 0 points. And obviously I use half of a small onion, which is 0 points. Sriracha is also 0 points. So it is a 8-point meal. So this is what it looks like.
I'm not super familiar with the Weight Watcher
app. And I logged my breakfast, which is only 8 points, and I still have 63 points remaining.
Okay.
I get
so
71.
That's good then, right?
Or yeah, 71. So that's a lot of points.
Now I shall take a bite. You know, I could have used cheese because the cheese that I used yesterday was 4 points, I think.
Mmm. Mm. So yes. Good.
Mmm. It's so good. I'm probably gonna have a Diet Coke, let's be real.
Predictable
list. I'm also gonna do a weight loss update here in a little bit. Mm. Oh, and by the way, today's American Horror Story Day, so let's get ready for that.
Hey guys.
Hey girl.
For you. Oh boy. Oh my gosh. So gorgeous. Hi guys.
Hey.
I was just wanting to show you really quick what I've been doing today. I know a lot of people were talking about the boxes I had made for Eric and Ricky for their birthday. So I decided to make myself one. I'm not nearly close to being done with it. I keep looking up in the viewfinder, I don't know why. So I just figured I would show you guys where I'm at with it right now. This is obviously supposed to be the front. And it's still trying to dry a little bit. I've had to add so many coats of paint because I just could not get the color right. I'm wanting to get that line straight or two for the bottom of the box and bring the gray up because there's more gray than there is the light gray. You know, see, I feel like I just don't have enough gray going on, and I'm going to try to work on that. You know, I've had to take many different colors of paint and try to mix them together because I first ended up with this one. It's like a pale gray, and it wasn't exactly what I wanted. So I tried to mix black with it, and as you can see, I was out of black. So I had to go to Walmart and get some more, which this is pavement. And also have this black too. Also pavement. I thought I got an actual black. I guess I'm wrong. Crap. I had to mix that with this to make like that kind of gray. That's what I've been trying to deal with all day long, and it's been sort of frustrating, and I don't know.
Very exciting.
I can't wait to get the outside done so I can start on the inside. I'm going to make this Super Mario, and down here I'm going to make it Duck Hunt.
Cute.
And that's where my idea is.
Love.
That's where my idea for this project has been going. I know people have told me, you know, make an Etsy, you know, take requests, make boxes on there, sell them, which, you know, is a really good idea, but I don't know if I'm like up to par with that.
Oh,
I could try. You know, I don't want to promise someone a product and it turns out to be really crappy because my skills aren't up to that standard, if you know what I'm saying. Anyway,
yeah, but they would know like what they were paying for based on your, you know, reviews and your past work. So that's sad that she like didn't feel like she was good enough to do that, because obviously didn't happen. That would have been like a cute idea. I'm sure somebody would have appreciated that.
I was wanting to show you all for now, and I hope whenever it is finished, it is to my liking and also to your liking as well.
Hey guys, so I just filmed a little video about me being in PewDiePie's video, and I'm just like,
oh, I remember that.
Why is it that big of a deal? No, I don't know. So I just wanted to give you guys a little weight loss, weight gain, weight situation update. I know a lot of people are constantly saying how I lie about my weight and not honest about my weight. I think that's a load of crock because I'm always very honest about my weight. If I was to lie, every time I come up on here, I'd be like, I'm down weight. I'm down 10 pounds. I'm down 20 pounds. I'm losing that weight. Like, no, like I'm completely raw and honest about the whole situation. So here I am with another starting weight. What accent was that though? I always try to do accents and I fail at them. But I weighed in a few days ago at 545. And Becky weighed in at 289. See, my whole, I just sneezed, so if my face is really red, that's the situation.
It's okay, forgive
but
you.
But I edited out the sneeze because it was rather loud and I didn't want to scare anyone, so. My whole situation is, Weight Watchers is great. You know, I did my points today. I went over by like 30. But Weight Watchers, for someone like me, I don't know, I'm a little scared by it because I had McDonald's for dinner and then I was like, oh look,
I know this is like irrelevant because this was 2 years ago, but you have to use common sense. Obviously McDonald's is not a good choice. The Weight Watchers program, technically, they want you to buy like their pre-made meals and stuff, right? They're not expecting you to go to McDonald's. And while you can log like, okay, beef patty, bread, bun, whatever, you can't log like the fat content, the oils they use, the salt content, that kind of stuff. So that's user error. That's not Weight Watchers' fault. Just throwing that out there.
Points. So I had a Ben and Jerry.
Again, that's user error, not Weight Watchers, girl.
I don't know. So I'm kind of just like, what the fuck? So I was talking to Becky and I was just like, I don't know how to lose weight anymore. Like, I literally don't know what to do anymore. I just keep gaining and it's frightening. And I know a lot of people are worried about me, a lot.
Yeah.
I'm worried about 100%. Myself because I've noticed a few instances where I'm just like, what? When did this happen? Like, how did this happen?
Yeah, it's
not really things I want to talk about right now, so maybe we'll talk about it some other time. But I will say I have noticed some situations where I'm just like, the weight gain is for real. Like, this is for real. Mm-hmm. It's not just a number on the scale. Sometimes in my brain I'm like, it's just a number, it's cool, it's fine. It's not. I can barely breathe just sitting here. Like, yeah. I keep having to take breaths and I'm just like,
it's just a number to an extent. From my own personal research that I've done, obviously I'm not a professional, it's true that you can be healthy in a bigger body. When you're in a body this large, you just can't tell me that there's health connected with that. I'm not saying that you can't be beautiful, because obviously you can, and I think she's beautiful and whatever, but holding that much weight on your body, it's gonna have some serious repercussions. Even if you lose the weight and you get to, you know, your body's happy weight, you're still gonna have permanent lifelong consequences for that. You're gonna have organ damage, you're gonna have bone damage, you're gonna have muscle damage. There's a lot of issues with holding extreme amounts of weight on your body. And it kind of makes me sad that this in 2018, she seems to be taking that more seriously. And over the years, she kind of has just given up on herself. And that makes me sad because I want to see her. I do genuinely want to see her around for a long time. I think she is such a fascinating, interesting person to watch. And that's why I like doing reaction videos, because like, I'm invested in her life. I'm invested in her story. I'm invested in the characters in her story. Like, she is just such a character. So I guess selfishly, that's why I want to see her around, because I want to watch her and I want to see her healthy. I want to see her having kids someday. I want to see her around for her pets. And that's why I worry when I notice that she continues just to gain and gain and gain. And it just, that's why these patterns of her like trying some kind of fad diet and then failing and then gaining more weight and then, you know, continuing this cycle cycle, it's worrying to me because I know just how much stress and damage that's just doing to her body and just stacking on and literally just taking years of her life away, her precious life that has so much value and she could do so much with her life with those years she's losing. It's just sad. And I just want the best for her. Even if she's done a lot of things I don't agree with, I truly want her to be happy and healthy. That's all I want. Even if it's only a 100-pound weight loss, that would bring me so much peace and happiness because that would add to her life and it would subtract from suffering.
What is happening? So of course, yeah, I can lose weight doing Weight Watchers and still eating McDonald's and sticking below a certain amount of points, but do I want to lose weight eating McDonald's? No,
don't.
I feel horrible after I eat foods like that, and I just feel so much better when I eat healthier things, and so I think I just need to start focusing more on that, really.
So a bit of a jarring end to her video there. She didn't do an intro or an outro, but you know, she's stepped up since then. So that was today in 2018. I think it would be interesting if she does take like a longer hiatus to just continue doing that and like see what she was doing like today, X amount of years ago. I think that'd be really cool. Like retro-react, but specific dates, you know what I'm saying? If you're down for that, let me know. If you'd rather me do something else while she's taking a little break moment, you know, happy to hear your suggestions. I'm here to please you. I love you so much it hurts. Let me know what you guys thought. Do you agree with what I'm saying? Do you disagree? Like let's have a conversation. What are you thinking? Had she improved? Maybe I'm totally off base. I don't know. Please don't forget to like, subscribe, and comment on your way out so you can stick around to see all that good content grandma puts out for you. I upload every Tuesdays and Thursdays at 3 p.m. EST, and I love you very much. You are cherished. You are beautiful. You are wonderful. I love you so very much. You are my grandchild and I adore you. Please don't forget to bring a cardigan because it's chilly outside and I don't want you to catch a cold. Don't forget to wear a mask, social distance, be responsible, wash your hands, and I will see you next time.